Did you know that the most important person that you can ever influence is yourself? Do you do that? Many of us neglect to develop and improve our influence on ourselves because we feel that it is unnecessary. Today, I want to talk to you about self-influence and the power that it can have on your life. Let's get started. Hey there, I'm Aparna, your personal coach, helping you upskill yourself to lead the life you desire. It's easy for us to say that we do not need to influence ourselves because there are so many external influences in our life. And these could be the result of your education, your culture and upbringing, your relationship, even your age and gender. And I'm not even mentioning the extensive influence media has over us. But these are all external. Self-influence works internally. It's what you think, believe, and perceive about yourself. Psychologists or psychological science calls it the self-concept. Self-concept is a picture of who I think I am as a person. It's not the same as labeling, but it goes much, much deeper, right down to the bottom of your belief system. So why am I talking about self-influence or self-concept? Because when your internal perception of yourself is strong, the external influences can be little or no help to you at all. I mean, the positives you can still absorb, but the negatives that get pushed to you won't make any difference to you. Carl Rogers, a renowned humanist psychologist, believes that there are three distinct parts of a person's self-concept: self-esteem, self-image, and ideal self. Self-esteem is how much we value ourselves. A good level of self-esteem aligns to happiness, well-being, and success in life. But did you know that most of us suffer from low self-esteem? Ironically, we don't really like ourselves much. And if that's true to you, then people around you are not just influencing you, but also controlling you. But you can always increase your self-esteem, and I will cover that in future episodes. But if you are not able to increase it on your own, then I suggest you hire a coach to help you. There is also a flip side. Too much of self-esteem can lead to narcissism, feeling of superiority, and unrealistic view of ourselves. Self-image is how we see ourselves. It's the mental picture in our head, irrespective to whether it's a reality or not. It's how you think and feel about yourself based on your appearance, performance, and relationships, which impacts the outlook on life and your happiness as well. When you have a healthy self-image, you are no longer influenced by other people's opinions and expectations. You tend to make up your own mind, and as a result of it, you are more optimistic, tend to have more confidence in yourself and your ability. Ideal self is a person you want to be. It's an ideal version that you create of yourself based on your experiences and even imitating your role model. We picture ourselves as this ideal self who has achieved all his goals, is living his life to the fullest, and is very happy and successful in life. So the bottom line is, in order for you to have a healthy self-concept or begin to influence your own self, you need to know yourself, love yourself, and be true to yourself. Developing this needs deliberate planning and concentrated effort. Next week, I'm going to talk to you about how you can develop your self-influence. So if you have any questions about the topic, do leave it in the comment section below or reach out to me in any of the social media platforms that I'm on. That's it from me. If you like this video, do give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, subscribe, and also hit the bell button so you'll never miss an update from me. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful time. I'll see you next week. Bye.